Welcome to TechToast channel. This is for the tech by your tech. In this video, we will see HbA1c, that is glycated hemoglobin, in detail. Hemoglobin is iron containing metalloprotein in red blood cells that carries oxygen to organs and tissue and transport carbon dioxide from organs and tissue back to lungs. Hemoglobin is an assembly of four globular protein subunits lightly associated with non-protein prosthetic iron-containing heme group. In normal adult, around 97% have type A1 hemoglobin containing 2 alpha and 2 beta globulin chains. Type A2 are 2 to 2.5% having 2 beta and 2 delta, and HbF in small amounts having 2 beta and 2 gamma globulin chains. A small amount of hemoglobin A1 have glycation of glucose and N-terminal valine of the beta chain to form HbA1c. The amount of glucose attachment depends on the amount of glucose present in the circulation. In diabetes, more amount of glucose is attached due to increased level of glucose and raise the level of HbA1c. The red blood cells lifespan is around 120 days. The estimation of HbA1c is a good diagnostic tool for diabetic persons for last 2 to 3 months of glucose level. Sample collection. 2 to 5 ml of whole blood is collected in EDTA anticoagulant containing tube and mixed well to prevent clot formation. Minimum 1 ml of whole blood is required for testing. Micro collection tubes are not acceptable. The sample is transported at refrigerated temperature. The frozen samples are not accepted. Sample is stable at room temperature also. Testing method. The amino acid substitution result in an alteration of the net charge, which is used in charge-based methods of HbA1c measurement. High-performance liquid chromatography, electrophoresis, cation exchange chromatography is used this method. Amino assay based method utilizes antibody that identify the N-terminal glycated amino acid. Immunoturbidometry, enzymatic, point of care test are done by this method. Normal range. Normal range is below 6%, that is below 42 millimoles per mole. Pre-diabetic 6% to 6.4%, that is 42 to 47 millimoles. Diabetes 6.5% and over, that is 48 millimoles and over. Contraindications. Labile HbA1c. Pre-HbA1c or labile HbA1c is an intermediate in the synthesis of HbA1c having reversible binding of glucose to hemoglobin as a shift base. The amount varies person to person, could fluctuate HbA1c level. Therefore, sufficient removal of this fraction is important for accurate estimation. Lifespan of the red blood cells. The lifespan of red blood cells is a key determinant of hemoglobin concentration. Hemolytic anemia, acute or chronic blood loss causes inaccurate results. Hemolytic anemia and renal anemias can lower the results. Iron deficiency anemia raise the value and fall after replacement therapy. Uric and lipemic samples may falsely elevate the results in charge separation method. Abnormal Hb variants. Hemoglobin S, hemoglobin E, hemoglobin C, hemoglobin D are the most common abnormal variants. The amino acid substitution result in an alteration of the net charge, causes inaccuracy in charge-based method of HbA1c estimation. Any mutation involving that particular epitope in variant Hb will interfere with immunoassay-based HbA1c methods. Carbonated hemoglobin. In uremic patients, carbonated hemoglobin is elevated, which has similar isoelectric point to HbA1c, and that can interfere with charge-based methods. Hemodialysis will decrease the red blood cells lifespan, which significantly affect the HbA1c level. Medicines and supplements which affects the test. Iron, vitamin B12, and folate supplements, erythropoietin therapy, aspirin treatment, vitamin C or vitamin E supplement, certain viral and antimicrobial medicines can affect the test. Another test is fructosamine, which is similar to HbA1c. Patient with disease conditions which interfere with HbA1c can be tested for fructosamine. Fructosamine measurements are based on albumin instead of hemoglobin. Any condition change in albumin level will affect the fructosamine levels, and as the albumin's half-life is only 20 days, fructosamine reflects only 1 to 2 weeks blood glucose level. Thanks for watching. Please do write your questions, feedback in the comments and subscribe TechQuest channel. Thank you.